Hi everybody, I'm Siwe, and in today's video I'm going to show you 3 simple mind control projects you can build using the Neuroscope MindWave headset and an Arduino. So, let's get started. Okay, the first project we are gonna do is the mood light project. Here you can see it, it's using an Arduino and an RGB LED which changes on your mood. Okay, now you can see I have the headset on and the program is running, the C-sharp program here. You can see the different values, and so when it's very low, it's I'm very relaxed, and when it becomes higher, it becomes more stressed. So 0 is very, very relaxed, and 100 is that you are completely stressed out. Here you can see the mood light. When I'm relaxed, it's green, but when my mood changes to getting stressed, it will become more red, how more stressed I am. It is hard to demonstrate it because I can't get stressed on commando. So to demonstrate it, my friend is going to tell me a joke. If correct, my brain activity should go up and thus the LED should turn red when I'm laughing. So let's watch it.
Okay, so Siwe, you know it's winter?
Yeah.
What's the difference between a snowman and a snowwoman?
One is man and the other is a woman?
No, the one has snowballs.
Okay, that's a pretty good one.
As you can see, the LED became red when I heard the joke, which means it's working. Let's now go to the second project.
The second project I'm gonna show you is this one. Here you can see a relay, which is also controlled by an Arduino. When I think very hard about this LED going on, the relay will turn on, which will in turn turn the LED on.
Here you can see the LED with the program running in the background. I'm going to focus really hard on the LED. In the background, the ATT value must be higher than 60 to turn the LED on. So, now let's try it. As you can see, the LED turned on. So now I'm going to turn it off again. To do this, I have to lose focus on the LED. The easiest way to do this is just to look around and get distracted. In the beginning, it is hard to control the LED, because it requires a different kind of thinking. It is hard to explain, but you really have to focus on the LED in a special way. After a while though, it becomes easy and you can control it almost instantly.
Okay, in the stairs example, I'm going to show you this RGB LED strip. This is an individual addressable LED strip, which means I can turn every RGB LED strip LED on and off. So, how this RGB LED strip is like the mood light example, connected to my brain with my meditation value. So, if I'm becoming more stressed in my head, the RGB LED strip will become more light up and will become more red, to how more it comes to the end. And now, if I'm getting very relaxed, it is going to be very green and very here.
To demonstrate, I am playing Flappy Bird. As you can see, when I fail, I become more stressed and thus the LED strip becomes more red. Flappy Bird is a great game to demonstrate this, because it is a game in which you can fail very easily and thus you get stressed quickly. Here you can see very nice how my stress level is building up, how further I'm getting in the game. And you can also see, when I fail, my stress level also increases.
Okay, so you're now thinking, okay, Siwe, that's pretty cool, but how does it work? So, I will explain. So, you have yourself here, some eyes, and like a big smile on your face. Okay, and this is called an EEG reader. So it reads your mind using the EEG technology. So what is the EEG technology works as follows. So you have your brain with a lot of neurons in it. Between those neurons, there are a lot of electrical signals. These differences in electrical signals between these neurons can be detected using the node on this EEG reader. So the EEG reader detects these nodes like this, like a big wave. And this wave is then sent to the computer, And the computer then processes this.
So, the computer processes all the data from the NeuroSky headset. The NeuroSky headset will send a value between 0 and 100 to this receiver, which then goes to the C-sharp program. Okay, so here you can see the TG parser that parses data that contains key attention. This gets the attention value, which is just between 0 and 100. So here you can see an if statement. If the data received by the from the ear headset is higher than 60, then the variable R equals 1. Else, if the parsed data is lower than 60, it will send 0. And here you can see it will send create a message with the R value 1 or 0. So if the R value is 1, it will send here. It was sent here to the Arduino 1, and if the value is 0, it was sent 0. And this is 1 for turning the relay on and 0 for turning the relay off.
The 1 or 0 value from the C-sharp program is then sent to the Arduino over the USB cable. On the Arduino, there is just a simple program that looks if it receives 1, it turns the LED on, and when it receives 0, it turns the LED off.
Okay, just to recap, in today's video we have learned how to use an Arduino and an EEG mindset reader to control things with your mind. So the examples I show you were pretty cool, but it can of course go a lot further. In the future I want to upload a new video where I show you BCI, which stands for Brain Controlled Interface. When you use BCI, you can for example control a drone like this one with your mind. This works by using the machine learning. If you, for example, want to let the drone fly, you will think about letting the drone fly up, and this will give certain values from the EEG mind reader. You can then give a machine learning model these values and say, okay, when they are on this value, the drone needs to go up. And if you have learned this to the machine learning model, you can build a program around it, which can control the drone. So if you want to see that, stay tuned, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.
I really want to thank subscriber Kasim Wami for giving me the idea to do a project with brain control. If you know also a cool project I should make, leave a comment down below.